When I defined the dot product of two vectors as the product of their magnitudes times the cosine of the angle between them, I used that to explain why the dot product is commutative. That's because the cosine of the angle theta doesn't matter whether the angle theta is defined from going from vector A to vector B or going from vector B to vector A. Those two angles will be negatives of each other, but the cosine of an angle is the same thing as the cosine of its negative. Cosine is symmetric about zero. There's another very convenient way to calculate the dot product of the two vectors if they're given to you in component form. So here, this looks very busy, but let's just take a minute to unpack it. Here what I'm saying is I'm defining or expressing the two vectors in terms of their components. So vector A is equal to its x component, a sub x, times the unit vector I hat, plus its y component, a sub y, times the unit vector j hat, that's in the y direction, plus the z component, a sub z, times the unit vector k hat, that's the unit vector in the z direction. Or we can just refer to it as an ordered triple, or an ordered pair if you're only worrying about two dimensions, and that's the x component, the y component, and the z component. B is defined in the same way. B sub x is the x component times I hat, the unit vector in the x direction, b sub y, the y component times the unit vector j hat in the y direction, b sub z times the unit vector k hat in the z direction. The dot product of these two vectors A and B is going to be given by the sum of the products of their components. What I mean is, you take the x components, multiply them together, the y components, multiply them together, and the z components, multiply them together. Then you sum those products. So it's the sum of the products of the different components. You see when this happens right away that the result is going to be a scalar. All the vector nature of this has been taken out. There's no multiplication by unit vectors. Each term is just a number. The end result is just a number. It has no direction. You can also see that by this definition, the dot product is going to be commutative. It doesn't matter if you multiply the A component first or the B component first. A times B is the same thing as B times A. So just as multiplication of numbers is commutative, dot product of vectors is commutative. Another cool result of this is that dot product notation is a very quick way to designate vector magnitude. Conversely, it's sometimes convenient to think of magnitude in terms of dot products. Let me explain what I mean. So if you take a dot product of a vector with itself, if you're thinking of the vectors as magnitudes and directions, well then that would be vector A dot vector A, the magnitude of A times the magnitude of A times the cosine of the angle between them. If it's the same vector, the angle between them is zero. The cosine of 0 is 1, so that just gives us a squared, the square of the magnitude of vector A. If you look at the vector as components, then vector A dot vector A is going to be AX times AX plus AY times AY plus AZ times AZ. Well, that's just the square of AX plus the square of AY plus the square of AZ. It's the sum of squares of the components. So the dot product of a vector with itself is the square of the vector's magnitude.